Hey everyone, what we can know about the universe comes from what we can see, and what we can see is limited by the speed of light. So there must come a boundary, an edge beyond which we know nothing about. This is about cosmic edges, the edge of our vision. First up, whatever we see is delayed by the time it took for light to reach us. Everything we see is already in the past, but luckily, the speed of light is so fast in earthly frames, we don't really notice a difference. But when it comes to observing the universe, it has real physical consequences. The two facts that are the most important here are first, the finite speed of light, and second, the expanding universe, or more accurately, the accelerating expanding universe. The universe is expanding, and because of dark energy, things that are further away are moving away from us even faster. Which implies there must come a distance at which things are moving away from us faster than the speed of light. So does that mean we would never be able to see anything outside this distance? Well, not so fast, because even though it feels logical that since space is expanding faster than the speed of light, things outside would never be able to flow faster than the speed of light against this cosmic expansion to reach us. However, a counterintuitive idea emerges once we learn about the actual dynamics of the universe's expansion, the dynamics that come from Friedman equation. There is something called the Hubble constant, which essentially is a measure of how fast the universe is expanding. The crux is, even though things in the universe appear to be moving away from us at an accelerating rate, the inherent expansion rate is actually not increasing. I know, it would have become really confusing because we hear all the time that the universe's expansion rate is accelerating, but bear with me. It will make sense. So, if the inherent expansion rate of the universe is not increasing, is it a constant? Well, even though it's called a constant, Hubble constant, it's actually not really a constant. It's called a constant because it's constant at a particular time for the entire universe. It's also known as the Hubble parameter, if it helps. But it does change with time, and it might be a little counterintuitive, but of all the things in the world, it's actually decreasing. And no, it does not mean that the universe is not expanding faster and faster. Things that are further away are indeed moving away from us faster than things close by. What it actually means is that the rate itself is decreasing. It is still expanding faster and faster with distance, but the absolute number of it is slowing down. I think we need an example. Suppose there's a galaxy a certain distance away that is receding away from us at some random speed, let's say 55 kilometers per second. After some time, its distance from us would increase further and it would appear to be moving away from us at an even faster rate, let's say 60 kilometers per second. This is the accelerating expansion of space. Then what is the Hubble constant? Well, with time, at the same distance as originally, a different galaxy would appear to be receding away from us at a speed slower than the original galaxy was. Let's say 50 kilometers per second. These numbers are totally made up, by the way, so don't worry. However, it would still be moving away from us at an accelerating rate. With time, its distance from us would further increase, and eventually there would come a point at which it would appear to us to be receding away from us at 55 kilometers per second, but at a larger distance than original. How is this relevant to the Hubble sphere? Well, at the boundary of the Hubble sphere, space is expanding at the speed of light. Right now. But at a later time, this would happen at a larger distance, growing the Hubble sphere. So any light ray that was originally outside the Hubble sphere could come inside and therefore could reach us in a finite amount of time. However, that doesn't mean that there's no limit to how far away we can see, because even though the expansion rate is slowing down, it's not going to go all the way to zero. Rather, it would asymptotically reach a value of around 55 to 60 kilometers per second per megaparsec. Don't worry about the units though. A megaparsec is just a clever unit of distance. A parsec is around 3.26 light years. A megaparsec would be 3.26 into 10 raised to 6 light years. Huge distance. So there does come a point beyond which any signal emitted right now would never be able to reach us. But this distance is not the Hubble sphere. What is it then? Well, it's called the event horizon. So this one is not related to black holes. The Hubble sphere was around 14.4 billion light years in radius. The event horizon is slightly a bit more, but not a lot more. it's around 16.6 billion light years in radius. Things happening outside of the event horizon right now would never be able to send any signal to us. We would never know whatever is happening outside of the event horizon. And that's scary, man. And we have entered the unknown territory. Finally, there's one last catch. Even though nothing outside of the event horizon right now could ever send any signal to us or get to us, there were things in the past that were once inside our event horizon, but with the expansion of the universe have now been moved further away. But the light that they emitted back then, it's still inside the event horizon and therefore could technically reach us. And therefore, as of now, the furthest light that we can see comes from these regions that are now far beyond the event horizon, the true edge of our vision, the particle horizon, also known as the observable universe, which is about 46.5 billion light years in radii. The light from anything outside that has not have had enough time to reach us in the 14 billion year history of the universe. And similar to the Hubble sphere, the observable universe as well is growing in size and would reach a finite value asymptotically, of course. So as of now, with time, we would be able to see a little bit more of the universe. Depressingly though, the event horizon is shrinking. And so with time, there would be less and less of the universe from which light emitted right now would ever be able to reach us. Which means even though we would be able to see a bigger universe, we would be in contact with less and less of it. In some sense, we are still at a very good time in the universe to have been able to detect what all we could. Because after a while, things are just so much receding away from us that there would not be many things that would be visible in the night sky. And we would be oblivious to the plethora of things that exist in the universe, simply because light from those objects would never be able to reach us. We would have very little idea of what's happening in the recent local universe. And that time would come, but not anytime soon, so rest easy and have a nice time. Thanks for watching.